As the cars roll out on the speedway, the rest of the field looks like this. Zach Zilke in the 1C, 15AW of April Lewis in the 5C of Connor Mahoney, 31D of Bruce DeWitt, NZ of Avery Daniels, Scott Kirk in the 43, 4 of Eric Smith in the 4Z for Wayne, the 11 in the 3rd, 5 in the 7th, the 14W of Bruce DeWitt, 7th in Graham, Tommy Wickham, the 22-8, Matt Hammer. All hands on deck. 4 weeks apart, that could start this week. No, no, no.
They didn't hear it. Did they hear him on show? Sorry, just blame me. Yellow's still out there as they work off the Joe B. the 50. Stuck at the top of turn number two.
Can we have this replay that we're getting past? So far, you see most of the drivers stay out on course.
Yeah.
We can make some laps. Only one driver. There's no provisionals here from this point forward.
How many laps are we going, Rich?
15.
A lot of time still left in this one. If you're inside the top five or so, you're stuck back there at 20. You're holding the back. Of all these guys, I have not seen it happen yet. We've got a lot of these drivers. These are the last competitor last season.
Yeah, very well could be.
A lot of these guys, you won't see them travel down to New York. A lot of our local guys, this is it for them. They don't put the cars away for the winter. So a lot of them, this is their last chance to have some fun in 2012. Of course, there are no street car races happening around here. For a lot of these guys, this will be it.
Now, it's an auspicious stat to be in, but three of the four drivers that have competed in every Saturday night of the Canadian Nationals are in this race right now. They won third and fourth. Rick Wilson was out there back and forth, and got connected to the other in the Canadian Nationals.
That's why we're
ready to
go this time. Rich on turn four, they're telling them. Bunch it up, like they will leave one lap car. Joe Beaver will line up between Charlie Sanderbach and Tom Huffman.
Don't count out Paul Kenny. Mike Sparks, they have been on the move. Using different lanes, and I tell you what, the way the bottom can box up sometimes, but Mikey might have a shot on the outside.
We really got a tiptoe around the outside as Tommy comes on our radio mentions. Randy Hannigan has moved up a ton as well, Rich.
That's right. Okay, Slade is third 38. That didn't happen. He turned off 28. But in any event, he is running in 8. 28 to 8. 8 laps is impressive.
Not sure where they're trying to put Zach Zumpy in here, but
yeah.
I'm sure Kenny and Kretschka and Dempster would wish that he would just take it out of the way. You would have to go a lap to the field, but I mean, we're looking for one driver. You're down a lap, tough sled in the head for you. White flag out, we're ready to go this time on a turn 4.
Yeah.
I don't think anybody in the top of the vehicle has a legitimate shot at turning Sanderbach's position. Good off the board in the middle. That's good. He's been loose. And he goes a little quick there. Sanderbach took him right there.
This car in a mess down here with the 57 of Charlie Sanderbach.
What is that debris though?
They got caught up behind Scott Church 43, a little indecision, and then rode the right rear wheel and a hard flip in the wall.
How about it, folks? Charlie Sanderbach, all right here, having a great run and sees it all go away in turn one.
Looking for him to throw the yellow for the chunk right in the middle of the groove. And now it's like the leader's wrecking. Hannigan's freaking second, 4 laps to go. Holy crap. What?